Hello, I'm Dr. Deepak Bhatt from Brigham and Women's Hospital and Harvard Medical School in Boston. It's really a pleasure to be able to speak to you today. I just finished giving the keynote address here at the American Society of Preventive Cardiology. The meeting's in sunny San Antonio. It's actually nice and warm here. Fortunately, I like it warm. And it's just been a terrific meeting overall. I was really privileged to start it off with a keynote address, and my talk was about Reduce It, going beyond LDL cholesterol lowering. That's the topic I was assigned, and I was happy to speak about it. And really, I first reviewed some of the key discoveries and trials in recent years with respect to LDL lowering, beyond just the fact that everyone at risk should be on a statin if they can tolerate it. But the trials that I discussed were ones beyond the sort of older trials that put statins on the map and focused on studies such as Prove It, showing that more intense statin is better than moderate intensity statin. Trials like Improve It, showing that we can go beyond statins, in that case with ezetimibe, and then briefly reviewing Fourier and Odyssey, just the whole PCSK9 inhibitor story, just illustrating how useful the science was there in bringing important therapeutics to cardiovascular prevention. So after just going through that, I talked a bit about triglyceride lowering and its promise and some of the pitfalls in the past. I reviewed the omega-3 fatty acid literature to date, largely with low doses of mixed EPA-DHA products, not showing any convincing, consistent benefit with respect to cardiovascular prevention. Reviewed the JELIS trial, which was a study of pure EPA that was positive, showing a benefit in both secondary and primary prevention in Japanese patients in an open-label, though randomized trial. Touched upon the CHERRY trial, which a lot of people don't know about, but which is a small study that showed that there was a difference in rates of progression of atherosclerosis on intravascular imaging with EPA versus control. That was an open label trial as well, no placebo, but still showing scientifically, I think, something important, that EPA can lead to plaque, if not regression, at least slower rates of progression, maybe both. So interesting signals and findings from that study that I touched upon. And then I talked a little bit about mechanisms of action of EPA and how it may have roles, not just in lowering triglycerides, but in combating arterial inflammation in terms of, as I mentioned from the CHERRY trial, potentially affecting rates of plaque progression in a favorable way, potentially having a mild but maybe clinically relevant effect on thrombosis, and a variety of other potential mechanisms, things like membrane stabilization that might have cardiovascular benefit. And then I launched into a review of the Reduce It trial, the main findings that were published in the New England Journal of Medicine, showing a 25% relative risk reduction in important ischemic events, including a 20% reduction in death due to cardiovascular causes that was significant. I reviewed the total events analysis or recurrent events analysis that was published in JACC that showed a 30% reduction in total events. And then some of the other findings that have come out as well, things like the blood pressure reduction that we saw in Reduce It, which albeit a modest reduction, was statistically significant, and also some of the triglyceride data, including a consistent benefit of icosapent ethyl across triglyceride tertiles. So really a review of the main data from Reduce It, a bit of discussion of how Reduce It fits into the larger context of cardiovascular prevention that is not competing with but complementary to LDL lowering strategies and other cardiovascular prevention strategies in general. And then finally, a bit of a review of the American Diabetes Association 2019 guideline update, where they give a level A recommendation, that's the highest level of recommendation they have, to the use of icosapent ethyl in both secondary and primary prevention in patients with elevated triglycerides, which they define there as in the range that we studied in the Reduce It trial pretty much. So really a review of not just Reduce It, but how it fits into the larger context, and I think how it nicely complements other studies in cardiovascular prevention.